evening. I'm Rachel Maddow. It's been a wild and controversial week in the U.S. Senate, beginning Tuesday when Rod Blagojevich appointee Roland Burris showed up, hoping to take his seat as the newest senator from Illinois, only to be turned away at the front gate. Mr. Burris joins us now from Washington.
Hello, Rachel. Please call me Senator Burris.
Well, that's not official yet. It's been quite a week for you. Tell us what happened on Tuesday.
All right, Rachel. As you know, I was appointed by my dear friend, the honorable and recently impeached Governor Rod Blagojevich.
Yes, and because of that, you were warned many times that your appointment would not be recognized. Yet you flew down to Washington anyway.
I sure did, Rachel. I am a four-time elected official statewide, so I know when it's time to go to work. I went on Priceline.com, and I found myself a very reasonable ticket on Southwest Airlines. And before I knew it, I was landing at an airport within a 50-mile drive of the greater D.C. area. Priceline negotiator!
So you just showed up. What did you expect would happen?
Well, I expected to be sworn in and seated as a U.S. senator, but I guess it wasn't my day. I was told that my credentials were not in order, and I was kindly escorted out of the building. But don't worry, Rachel. I'm sure that the matter will be cleared up. I'm very qualified. I've held four state positions, and three of them have been comptroller.
Fair enough. Tell us what happened after you were turned away on Tuesday.
Well, on Wednesday, Rachel, I was very happy because I was able to meet with Senate Majority Leader Harry Reid, and that meeting was very productive.
And what did he say?
Well, he told me that my credentials were not in order, and I was escorted out of the building.
Sorry to hear that. What happened the next day?
Well, on Thursday, I proudly walked through the Senate doors. And then after breaking away from my tour group, I noticed that someone had left a fire exit open. So I proceeded to take my rightful place as junior senator by commando crawling through the ceiling vents. As I was approaching the Senate floor, I collapsed through the ceiling, causing me to plunge into some kind of a coffee break room.
And what happened then?
I was told that my credentials were not in order. And again, I was escorted out of the building and given the telephone number to a local Jamaican taxi service.
Yes, we have a picture of that. Now, it looks like you're wearing a disguise of some sort.
Yes, I thought my fellow senators would find it humorous.
Okay. So, did you try again on Friday?
No, Rachel. See, last night I needed to blow off a little steam, so I went to a popular D.C. nightclub called Oxygen. There, I explained to the gentleman at the door that I was a four-time elected official and three-time comptroller. But when I got there, I was told that my credentials were not in order, and I was escorted out of the building.
I'm sorry to hear that. Now, Harry Reid has stated that this has nothing to do with race. Do you believe that?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. Harry Reid never wanted this race to come to this. And I'm sure that the other 99 white senators feel the same way. They would love to see the black population of the Senate rocket up to 1%. Rachel, I'm a dreamer. And I envision a day when the U.S. Senate will have the same percentage of African Americans as, say, the state of Utah. Or the Country Music Awards.
Well, good luck to you, Mr. Burris.
Thank you.
Joining us now is the man who appointed Mr. Burris, Illinois Governor Rod Blagojevich. Good evening, Governor.
Yeah, you thought I'd gone away, didn't you? Well, sorry to spoil your party there, Billie Jean King.
Be pleased that your appointee might actually make it into the Senate, even after Harry Reid said he would never seat someone you picked.
I couldn't be happier, Ellen. No, it's like I said to Harry Reid on the phone, and I'm gonna watch my language here by substituting a word. I said, if you sex me, Harry, I will sex you so hard you'll wish you'd never been born. Then I told him to go sex himself, and I hung up the phone.
Governor, yesterday you were impeached by the state legislature 114-1.
Mm-hmm, yeah, it's closer than I thought. Yeah, you gotta understand, getting impeached in Illinois is nothing. It's like a prank, you know, it's just part of the swearing-in ceremony. You got me, Katie Lang?
I suppose. suppose. And you maintained your innocence in a press conference yesterday where you had several sick and handicapped people stand behind you. Don't you find that a little exploitive?
Exploitive? Sex you.
Governor, when will you leave office?
Never. Never, Chachi. I'm not going anywhere. I'm stuck here like a Dutch kid with his thumb in a dike. Sound familiar, Kyle MacLachlan?
Okay. Okay, I'm cutting you off. Thank you to Mr. Burris. No thanks to Governor Blagojevich. And live from New York!